Breaking news at 5, Savannah rapper Quando Rondo, whose real name is Tyquan Bowman, will be released from jail.
Yeah, this comes after a federal bond hearing today. WJCL 22 News' Andy Cole joins us live from outside the courtroom. And Andy, the hearing lasted several hours.
Yeah, it lasted 5 hours, in fact, Riley. I've been here all day since 10:30. The decision came down from federal magistrate judge Christopher Ray around 4:30 today. They will release the 24-year-old, whose real name is Tyquan Bowman, from federal custody ahead of the holidays based on a number of factors. In fact, the federal judge Christopher Ray mentioned that this was a difficult one. It was a difficult decision to make because both arguments were so complex. Now, during that five-hour hearing today, prosecutors presented several wiretap phone calls and said Bowman was a danger to himself and the community. Prosecutor Bradley Thompson played one particular phone call from Bowman while he was at the movie theater with his young daughter after he noticed 10 members of the rival gang show up. Now, Bowman asked the person on the other line of the phone to bring weapons to the theater. The defense, however, pointed out that no fights or shootings happened as a result of the phone call. They used another phone call the prosecution did saying that they found seven, or the person on the other end that called Bowman found several of Bowman's Percocets on a kitchen table near his four-year-old daughter. Tom Withers, the defense attorney, argued that Tyquan Bowman showed serious concern for his mistake and that they were making sure that this was rectified. Again, that magistrate judge, Christopher Ray, saying this was remarkably close, but ultimately decided to give him that $100,000 unsecured bond. Now, how that works is that he will be released as soon as he returns to federal prison, which is he's on the way back to the federal prison in Emanuel County now. As soon as he gets released from or processed out of there, he will be good to go. He does not have to pay any money unless he violates any conditions of his bond. And in fact, there are many conditions specific to Bowman, one of which that they have to that he must enter drug treatment, he must surrender his passport, he must remain inside his Richmond Hill home unless he has left the home for anything else, including any court-ordered activities like a job, like seeing your attorney, other things like that, and really has to limit all of his travel to the Southern District of Georgia. He also cannot contact any victims, witnesses, or co-defendants directly or indirectly, and that is just some of the conditions of his bond. Of course, Bowman is facing several other standard bond conditions. You can find the rest of those on our website, WJCL.com. We will continue to update it with additional information, but for now, reporting outside the U.S. District Court here in Savannah, I'm Andy Cole, WJCL 22 News.
All right, Andy, thanks so much for staying on top of the story.